We're in Millvale today, which is a small borough just outside of Pittsburgh. It's only about 3,700 people, less than a square mile. Somewhat similar to a number of our communities back home, very working class community. And it came together a couple years ago after a flood, and really as a community wanted to figure out, you know, what do they want their community to look like in the future? And they came up with a sustainable model where they're really investing in what they call eco-districts and solar energy. And so right now we're in a former Moose Hall that has a solar component to it where they actually get solar energy and power a lot of their systems.
These types of initiatives are only going to catch on.
But they have a microgrid, which is state-of-the-art technology, where if there's an emergency and the electrical system goes down, the grid goes down, they can actually power the building. This isn't for everyone. But what they found is that their community is flourishing. The people want to live here. Businesses are coming. In fact, they have very few vacancies. And it shows you that when you want to plan for your community, you've got to come together as a community and build a narrative. What do we want to highlight in our community? What do we want to be about? You know, we have great natural resources. We have the Shenango River, which is voted the River of the Year. Great outdoor spaces, a very sustainable living, livable community that has affordable housing. But we need a theme to really figure out, you know, what we want our community to be about in the future that people can rally around. Then you can draw and attract people as you market that. And so that's what Millvale has done. And it encourages me because they're a small community. You know, there are only 3,700 people. And yet they figured out a niche that they came around together, and now they're finding people want to live here, businesses want to move in here, they're thriving, they're setting themselves up for the future. We can do that too in the Shenango Valley and Mercer County. Let's roll up our sleeves, let's get together, and let's build a sustainable Shenango Valley.